Rollers Entertainment, HMV, we are in the building.
So from the get, you're going to shout out Harlem.
Yes, right? I am.
We don't even need to ask where you're from.
No, that's what I represent. It's in my blood.
It's in your blood.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
All right.
Born and raised.
We're going to get to that. So, you're 25.
Yes, I am.
You're a rapper.
Yes, I am. I'm an artist.
You're a rapper.
An artist.
You have one mixtape out. Right? Am I right?
Yes, I do.
The name of the mixtape is what?
This Is Me, Volume 1.
This Is Me, Volume 1.
Yes.
When did it drop?
It dropped in 07.
Yes. How's it been doing so far? For it to drop in 07 and we're in 2010.
I mean, when you're inside, you know, the exposure is not as much as you want there to be, but you gotta just keep grinding, you gotta just keep going. So, you know, I got another mixtape coming in April. It's called Thought Process.
So it took you another 3 years to drop out another mixtape?
Nah.
It's not even dropped. Is it even in the works?
Yes, it's in the works.
It's in the works. So it took you 3 years from your first mixtape in 07 to even think about coming up with another one?
Yeah.
But you have a volume one, it shouldn't have taken you 3 years to come on the volume two.
Well, you could say that, but you know, it's a lot that comes with dropping a mixtape. You know, it's a lot of money involved, and it's a lot of thoughts, and you know, you need support, and you also need, you know, the backup. So,
if I'm not mistaken, your background is that you had two affiliates that were part of Rough Riders, right?
Yes.
So it's like enough backup as needed to come out with a second mixtape.
Yeah, but, you know, people have their own, you know, journeys, their own paths, so, you know.
And what was yours?
It's to be here.
Is it?
Yes.
You're 25.
Yes.
And how long have you been rapping for?
Like 9 years, but I've been taking it serious for like six.
You've been rapping for 9, you've been taking it serious for 6. So far, you only have one mixtape under your belt.
Mm-hmm.
Where you going? What are you doing with yourself?
But I also have an album done. If a label says, Charles, do you have an album done? Do you have enough songs to at least present an album? I do. I got like 30 songs under my belt.
But just because it's good enough for you doesn't mean that's going to be good enough for a label. Because I do know the process of when you're trying to sign for a label, you might have 30 songs and all 30 of them could be trash. Just because you think
and then I'll go back in and record again. No problem, or I'll go back in there and record a whole new album.
Alright. So what's your process? You, what makes you great? Because I may be a little bit tough on you, but it's just, I've had a lot of Harlem artists here.
Okay. Hold on, Day, hold on. Give me 1 second. Latron.
Yes.
Did you hear the drop?
Yeah, I heard it drop.
You heard it, right?
I heard it drop. I'm here.
I don't want you to feel some kind of way.
No, I don't feel no kind of way. I'm here. I already know it's going to get worse. Like, this is just the beginning.
She's, I think she's the unsigned hype pick boy.
Nah, I like this, though.
So,
thank you.
I do. I really like this.
I don't know if y'all get back to what y'all do best.
So, as I was saying, you're from Harlem.
Yes.
Are you... I ask this with all sincerity. Are you using the fact that you're from Harlem to promote yourself? Because it's easier to say you're from a borough. I call it a borough just because it's a city within itself.
Mm-hmm.
It's easy to use that as a goat to make it just because so many artists have made it from there.
But I don't really think that means anything. Like, just because you're from Harlem, what does that mean?
It means a lot. It means there's so many.
It's a lot of artists that came before me from Harlem that made it, but what does that do for me? That doesn't do nothing for me.
Yes, it does. It does a lot. If I don't have
the right talent and I don't have that drive, mm-hmm. and just because I'm from Harlem, what does that mean? That doesn't mean I'm gonna make it.
Nice, very nice. See, that's
death. I'm just saying, like, you know, it's the truth.
So then,
I don't use being from Harlem, you know, to promote myself. Like I said, I just love where I'm from. So anywhere I go, I'm gonna say that I'm from Harlem, and I'm gonna say it proudly.
What type of artist do you use as some of your inspiration? I know you can't compare yourself to anyone, but who do you use as a lookout?
Artists like Nelly.
Why?
Ludacris.
Why Nelly?
Just the mainstream success.
Nice.
Just knowing that, you know, he came into the game and he did what he wanted to do, regardless of say about him. Oh, he's a Kenny Carter rapper or whatever it is. He just did him, regardless of what people said.
True. But he also did him during a time where pop music was on the live. Yeah. So an artist who was Kenny Carter had a chance to make it. That's why he hasn't come out in
the last
4 years.
Time is everything, you know what I'm saying? So he came in the right time.
Time is coming.
Now.
Have you made beats for your upcoming mixtape that you have coming out?
Not quite yet, but okay. I'm planning on doing that.
And on your first mixtape, you did it?
No.
Did you make songs with others, or
yeah.
Who did you make songs with?
As far as like artists that's underground.
It doesn't matter, it could be underground, whatever, mainstream.
Just mostly people in my camp, like HMU.
Okay.
Yeah, I kept it in the family.
And what is that, your camp?
Harlem Envy.
Harlem Envy?
Yeah.
People from Harlem Envy?
No.
So.
It stands for Harlem New Voices. HMV is abbreviation.
Harlem New Voices.
Yeah.
Yeah, you need to break that down.
Nah, it's just a group, a collective people. You know, we just hit all areas, fashion, music, everything. Anything, man, we got people that do it, sports. We got people in college that play football, basketball.
Nice. Very nice.
We got artists, people that draw.
So, like, being part of an area that everyone's out for themselves to make it. Because that's honestly what it sounds like Harlem's about at times.
You're right, though. It's a lot of egos, but I can't worry about the next, you know, person. I just gotta keep grinding and worry about what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? I could reach out to people and I could say, well, let's do this or let's do that, but if they don't want to do it, then I can't force myself to make them do it. You know what I'm saying?
What do you use? Like, do you use... How do you phrase your words? That's what I'm trying to say. How do you phrase your words when you spit a little bit? Do you use common objects? Do you use metaphors? Do you use abbreviations? Is your vocabulary strong enough to handle that?
Yeah.
Is it?
Definitely.
So spit something right now.
Okay. Okay. Let's do it. Okay. Rock. Harder. Stand up. Okay. Listen. Need to speak or live together. Come what you get when you rub wood together. Fire. Send anybody on the empire with 12 blunts is good, we know a higher. What I accomplish, it'll be hard to pass it. I need rehab. I got a money habit. Am I the hottest? You sound funny asking. They don't like what you eating. They want me faster. Nice planning. Fresh dungarees. You see that shit is all just under me. Oh, what you wanna be? Need help? Come to me. We call Lewis Harlem. That's what we run, see? HMV, who they admire. That's my rival. I'm a family guy. Quagmire. That guy. No Teddy Riley. Try me and watch it all. Backfire. I'm shitting, which means get a tissue roll. Chris clean, wrist clean, I can get your hoes. Money track out black, nigga roll. Beat up the deep band, Dan Bigelow. I get the dough, got green like Piccolo. Smile in my face, but I know they better know.